What's going on, guys? Fresh coming at you guys with a brand new GTA 5 Online video, and on today's video we're going to be going over the top 3 best ways to make money in GTA 5 Online solo. Now, I've previously made videos obviously on this topic, but not solo. Most of them you needed a friend with, and a lot of people were requesting for the best ways to make money in GTA 5 Online solo. So this is that video for you guys. If you guys can, do me that favor, and if you guys are new to my YouTube channel, make sure you guys hit the subscribe button. We're on the road to 100k subscribers. And yeah, let's get straight into this video. This video really doesn't have anything too crazy that you'll need for it. You obviously will need some stuff, and it is solo, so you will not need a friend to do this. You can do it completely on your own and make all the money you guys want in GTA 5 Online and get rich really fast. Now, the first method, obviously, I've actually gone over this before, is going to be the CEO vehicle warehouse. Now, if you guys do not have a vehicle warehouse, I don't know what you guys are doing. You guys are definitely going to want to make sure you guys get one. They are a little bit expensive. At first, it's like, I think the cheapest one's like probably 1.9 million. Probably 1.8 million, something like that. But trust me, you guys will make the money back fast. I will show you guys right now. Look how much money I've actually earned off doing it. You can see I've earned $9 million. So I've already obviously earned my money back from, you know, buying it. So buy a vehicle warehouse. And once you buy it, you're going to want to basically source these vehicles as much as you can. And you're going to want to hope and pray for top range cars. You can see right here, I got a top range car, the T20. And this is a great car to sell. You guys will see why it is a great car to sell here in a second. But yeah, just do these source vehicle missions, and they are very simple and easy. You can see I'm calling out my Oppressor Mark II, because like I always say, the Oppressor Mark II is like the best vehicle in the game to like move around with and do these missions with. So just do the source vehicle mission, and I'll show you guys how the mission actually is. Most of them are basically the same. You just got to go to the location where the car's at, kill the cops or shoot the enemies, get the car, bring it back to your warehouse, and that's basically mission wrapped over. And you can do this as many times as you want. There is really no cooldown. It's like a minute cooldown. So by the time you get to back to your CEO office, you guys should be able to do it again. Now here I go. I'm gonna go to the actual mission, and I'm gonna show you guys how this mission actually is. I'm gonna speed it up so you guys don't have to like watch the whole thing. So right here, you can see this is basically the gist of the mission. So you're gonna wanna go over to where the place says to source a vehicle. You're gonna wanna get a gun, and you're gonna wanna shoot all these people down and take the car that is there. So it should be a T20 because we actually got the T20, as you guys can see. But yeah, like I said, all these missions are really the same. You can see I shot the cops and took them down that fast. It is very simple. Just get the car. Now we're going to take it to the vehicle warehouse, and we're going to just sell it. And I'm going to show you guys how much you guys it actually sells for. Most of you guys probably know how much it sells for, but it is selling for a lot of money, and it's very easy money to make in GTA 5 Online. You can see I just got here. Now I'm going to deliver it to my warehouse. Once I deliver it to my warehouse, now I can go sell it in a public session. Now I obviously recommend being in a solo public session because it is very easy and you won't have to worry about online players coming to attack you while you're selling it. So make sure you are in a solo public session or a session with almost no people in it. And you guys can see right here, these are all the vehicles I have in here already, but the top range cars will sell for the most. So you guys can see how much my top range car sells for. You can see I have a FMJ that's top range and also the T20, but I'm gonna sell the T20. So just sell the top range car you guys have and click export, and you're gonna wanna click the most expensive option right here. Trust me, you'll get the money back. Now get press confirm, and now you're gonna wanna just customize the car like it says. So remove the tracker, just customize the car as you know wanna do so. So just customize it fast. I'll be back when I actually finish it. So here we go, I just finished making the car, and now once you fully upgraded the car, you can now sell the car to the specialist dealer and do the actual mission for it. So these missions are pretty simple. It's basically just driving to a location and receiving the money. That's really all there is to it. So you'll see right here, we get out of here, you can see we gotta go 3.4 miles away, or wait, yeah, 3.4 miles away, so it's not that far. It's right here. You can see we just made it to the location, and we actually lost a little bit of money because I crashed, but it's all good. $96,000 I made right there. You can see $96,000. That simple, guys. It's very simple and easy. You can keep doing this, and this is probably the best way to make money in GTA 5 Online solo and also for the RP as well. Now right here, we're gonna go and bring us on to the second best method to make money in GTA 5 Online solo. Now for this method, you are going to be needing a terabyte, or if you have a friend who has a terabyte, he can help you as well. But you're gonna want to have you or your friend go in the terabyte and start up this mission right here called Diamond Shopping. Now this mission is very easy and very fast to do. It takes literally like 2 to 3 minutes max. So start this mission up. You can see right here, I'm starting it up. And if you guys have an Oppressor Mark II, it will make this mission very easy and very simple. You guys will see what I'm gonna, you'll see why I mean that in a second here. So you can see I started up. You don't have to take the terabyte. The mission tells you to take the terabyte originally, but don't take the terabyte. Trust me, that just wastes time. The way that I'm gonna show you guys right now will make it take like 2 to 3 minutes max. So just get your Oppressor Mark II and just start heading to the location that I head to right now. You don't have to take the terabyte like it tells you. Just start heading to the location that I head to right here. But most of you guys probably know where this is. It's right here in the middle of Los Santos. Now come here, and you're gonna wanna blast everybody in the front door. Once you blast everybody in the front door, you're gonna wanna get off your Oppressor Mark II and then get a gun and you're going to want to get everybody inside the diamond shop. So just get everybody really fast. You can see I'm doing it really fast. Get everybody. And once you get the last guy right here, you can see once we get the last guy, boom, now we can get the diamond back. So just get the diamonds, and you can see, look at the timer, it's 28 minutes. The mission is like 29 minutes long, so it's already been 28 minutes. It's been only a minute so far. Now I'll just take it to the location that I show you right now in a second. You don't have to lose the cops, just go straight to the location that I'm showing you. And once you take it straight to the location that I showed you, right here, just deliver it. And look at the timing, 27 minutes. It took me 20, it took me 3 minutes to do this mission. Literally, I wasn't lying. It's like a 29 minute long mission, and we finished it in 27 minutes. So, or two minutes, what am I saying? My bad, I cannot speak. But yeah, that's the next money method to do. I'd recommend doing that as well. Now let's go to the next money method on this list. Now I don't have a whole bunch of gameplay because there's not really much explaining to do for it. But the next best solo way to make money in GTA 5 Online solo is doing these daily objectives. You can see, take a look at the bottom right or bottom left. I just completed all three of them and I got 30,000 cash and 5,000 RP. So this is a very great way to make money. And if you do 10 of them this week, you guys will get a bonus $1 million. You can do it on both of your characters to get 2 million and boom, that is a very easy way to make money. So that basically wraps it up for this top three solo ways to make money in GTA 5 Online. I hope you guys did enjoy. And yeah, I just want to quickly point this out. I'm sorry for the outro. Peace.
Did you jump? Did you jump? 'Cause I jumped.